Welcome back everyone to the HWBOT World Tour 2017. This is the Overclocking World Championship 2017 Poitiers. This is the only overclocking event going all around the world, and we're about to witness the awesome final between the extreme guys. We have Dancop, currently number one in the world. He's gonna face Niuulh, currently number four in France, but a crazy outsider. This is something he came out of nowhere. He succeeded to win against Wizardy in the semi-final, and now he's in the final against the first overclocker in the world, the best overclocker in the world, Dancop. So for you guys to understand exactly how this is gonna work, I will just go to the guys, explain a little bit more about the extreme part, because everything else was already explained to you guys in the amateur competitions. If you're just tuning in now, you can always ask on the live chat if you have any questions. All the people that followed the match before will be here to help you out. So I will just go around the different guys and explain you a little bit more about what is this about.
All right. Okay, so I will be going around the systems with the guys. We are here at the OCWC17. We're gonna have two awesome guys. We're gonna have Dancop right here. He's from Germany. This is the actually the best overclocker in the world. Just a quick questions for you, Dancop. How do you feel just before getting into the final?
I mean, I was here last year as well, and I'm very happy because I was able to boot into the OS this year.
Yeah, because last year, if you guys didn't know yet, you can go watch the replay on YouTube. Dancop accessed the final at the same event last year, but sadly never managed to get into the OS, never managed to submit any scores. And well, that was quite sad to see, but now you're here, you want to prove that you are the best overclocker in the world, right?
That should be my goal right now, no? I don't want to lose yet.
You don't want to lose again, right?
Yeah.
That would be bad, and you have the family here to support you as well.
Yeah, that's my biggest support right now. So yeah, we want to celebrate it in Paris tonight. So let's hope I will win.
We just hope that you're gonna have a good game with all the guys here, and especially facing Niuulh. You act as the best overclocker in the world. You are facing Niuulh. How do you feel facing him? That's gonna be the first time you can face someone like him, an outsider completely into these kind of competitions. How do you feel about him?
I mean, he showed some really amazing scores in the qualifier and in the semifinal. So I'm a bit afraid. So we'll see. His CPU lag is such an amazing CPU lag. I've never seen that before. So he got three chips and three of them were just great. So yeah. I think luck will decide, because he's an a very good overclocker as well. So yeah, that makes it very, very difficult for me.
All right, so we can't wait to see the competition going on. Good luck on these games. Let's go back to Niuulh, the French guy. Can you veux que le fasse en français ou en anglais? Okay, so we can try to do it in English, and if that doesn't work, I'm just gonna translate a little bit from him. So, Niuulh, how do you feel being in the final today, as you are a complete outsider, and that's the first time you do one versus one? How do you feel?
I'm happy to be arrive in there. So I'll do my best from the final, and I will see.
You won against Wizardy, that is currently number one in France. That was quite a shutout. I mean, people were expecting Wizardy to win and access the final against Dancop. How did you feel once you knew that he was not able to put better score than yours?
When I see I can run to 6.6 GHz, I feel lucky. I'm lucky he knows how to push his CPU, and the CPU just cannot run. So I'm lucky, and I just push the CPU.
Last question for me, how do you feel competing against the best overclocker in the world in the ranking right now?
It's a chance, and I'm getting I get it fun with, so I'm enjoying this moment.
Well, that's the thing, as Niuulh just said. Thank you very much, man. Good luck for this game. As Niuulh just said, most of the guys here are pretty much friends. We will be, as you can see, so for you guys to understand what is extreme overclocking, they will be using this support here. So this is replacing the all-in-one water cooling or the air cooling system that the people usually have. And they will use liquid nitrogen like this. So this is extremely cold. This is negative, almost negative 200 degrees. You have to be very careful to manipulate that. The guys here know exactly how to do it. So they will use this this big piece of copper and aluminium things to put the LN2 in there. It will evaporate, and this is what creates cold, if we can explain it like this. As you can see on the table, they will all be using Seasonic PSUs. That's the Snow Silent PSU. That's the Snow Silent series. If I'm right, this is the 750 watts. Model for it. They will all use the Team Group memory as well, just a regular DDR4 memory that you guys can buy anytime on the market. Of course, the CPU is a Core i7-7700K. This is the CPU you can mostly have in your new gaming PC. As you can see here, they have some insulation around it. It's because there is a lot of it's extremely cold, so it's going to create condensation around it, and you have to be careful with that, because you never want to have any water inside your computers. So as we can see, we have the two contestants now almost ready to go. I will go back to my stream and hand over the microphone to the dear judge, Timothée. So we will be able to tune in with our friends Buildzoid in the next few minutes. The two guys have to start. Buildzoid, it's up back to you. The rules state that they have to be in the BIOS. What else do they have to do before starting the match?
Well, they have to be above, I do believe, 20 degrees to start off with. So both of them are right currently at 40 degrees and 30 degrees. They also have to have the BIOS settings completely wiped, which I know this BIOS pretty well because I have the same motherboard. Not as well as either of these guys, probably, because I can't get my RAM to clock very well. However, this is currently set right now completely bone stock. So they're pretty much ready to go. We're just going to wait for the judge to give us the starting signal, and then we'll see them very quickly probably blaze through all the settings and get them configured for liquid nitrogen while pulling down the systems, because, well, some of the stuff you need to enable on Kaby Lake for overclocking, you can't actually for liquid nitrogen overclocking, you can't actually enable at ambient temperatures, because at ambient temperatures it doesn't work at all. So you need to pull the system down quite cold before you can actually go even colder, which makes Kaby Lake kind of unique, because a lot of other systems you can just go down, 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 down. So we now. Judge seems to be moving into position, so expect the competition to start very soon.
Indeed, and they have to choose the benchmark before starting. The judge will do the random draw, so that's a list of benchmarks that they have to do. So the benchmark is the software they're going to use to compare the performances that they have all together. The draw will be made by the judge we have here. This is Timothée Pinot. He's the judge at this competition, and it will be soon available for the things. Just checking that all the benchmarks are here. So we can see the two guys are pretty relaxed. Oh, yeah. So we got information that the judge is ready to go.
All right, guys. We are ready for the finals of the Overclocking World Championship Poitiers 2017 qualifier. A quick reminder that the winner of this match will get a ticket to the finals, as well as a nice package of prizes. Well, there's a package of prizes for both of you, so that's a good thing. Quick reminder of the rules. Every time you got a score, you raise your hand or you call me over. I validate the score, repeat the number, and then you can continue. There's no need for screenshots unless we have a benchmark which is limited to 6 gigahertz, then I need to see CPU-Z open, okay? All right? You cannot use the pre-saved profiles of the motherboards. This includes also the special profiles. If you are, for example, using the Apex board, such as the Dancop profile, even you will have to dial in the settings by yourself, okay? you can still save your profiles during the match. All right, a quick reminder of the benchmarks that we have for today. So we have 3D Mark 11 physics. 2D Mark 11's physics limited to 6 gigahertz. This means it's 6.00, okay? So anything above that is not gonna pass. GPU Pi for CPU 500M, Geekbench 3 Multi 6 GHz, HDBotX 265 1080p, SuperPi 16M, and SuperPi 8M. Any questions? You guys are ready?
Yep.
All right. So the highest ranked in the qualifier gets to veto first, so that's you, Dancop. So I'm going to do the first draw of the benchmark. So we got SuperPi 8M. You okay, Niuulh? You okay as well? Oh, you veto. All right. SuperPi 8M is gone. Next one, 3D Mark 11 Physics. Yeah, full out. You okay? Well, you use your veto, so you got no choice. All right, so it's going to be 3D Mark 11 Physics for the next 30 minutes. Are you both ready? You need to be above 20 degrees. That's correct as well. Let me switch over to my timer. The round is going to start in a few seconds. I'm just waiting for the green light from the guys over there. Okay, we are good to go. So, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
And there we go. This is it. This is the game, the final game we have here for the Overclocking World Championship 2017 here in Poitiers qualifiers. As you can see, they will go straight in and they will be competing on 3D Mark 11 and 3D Mark Physics score. So that's going to be quite impressive to see what they have to do. So as you can see, the LN2 is already floating. Bizoid, what can we expect from this 30-minute match?
Well, I'm not sure, honestly. We're definitely going to be seeing very high clocks. I think all the CPUs currently at the event have been going well over 6 gigahertz. So, you know, we will be, clock-wise, we're going to be seeing some very high numbers. And this is interesting. So Niuulh is actually dialing in all his memory timings right now, while Dancop is setting his voltages. Starting off, could we get Dancop's screen?
Wait, actually, that's the other way around.
Oh, they're switched around? Wait, like Dancop isn't blue and Niuulh isn't red?
No, that's good, that's good. That wasn't my end. All right, let's go. So The red is Niuulh and Dancop is the blue one, either on the screen or on the pictures.
Okay, so it is correct. So yeah, Dancop is just setting up all his voltages and his power limits. Niuulh is dialing in memory timings. Right now,
if,
so
if we look a little bit closer, Niuulh is Dancop, sorry, is already setting up at 1.55 volts and the DRAM voltage is at 1.87. That is quite high for DDR4, but the guys are ready to go full out on this.
So Dancop has seemingly finished his baseline profile that he wants to be running. So this is probably, if he needs to restart and needs really clean settings, he's going to go off of this profile right here that he saved. So he's still pulling the system down. He did dial in a lot of the voltages that are necessary for KB Lake to actually work under, you know, at very low time, below minus 120 degrees with no cold boot bug. He already set those all up. So now he actually has to pull the system all the way down before he can actually apply that. Otherwise, the system won't boot.
So there we go. He will restart. And if we look at Niuulh, he is already restarting as well. So in the meantime, there was a few information from the judge, Xiala, about what they could do and what they could not do. The main reason is these people, extreme overclockers, they are working with industry, motherboard manufacturers, etc. And for example, Dancop closely work on beta testing the Apex motherboard. And and sadly, there is a profile in the BIOS that you can just start.
It's very good.
But that's his profile, so he doesn't have the right to use it. No one have the right to use that kind of profile inside these high-profile competitions. The main reason is, I mean, they are here not because they are close to the industry. They are here because they are good at what they do. And how do you know you're good at what you do is that you can die in the system.
To some extent, having a profile in the motherboard BIOS says you're pretty damn good at what you do. But
maybe one day we'll have the Buildzoid profile for AMD Ryzen.
No. That'll be the suicide profile. They won't even give my name to it. It'll just be like, kill your CPU quickly. Defaults maximum voltage. Disables any safeties. But, yeah, no, Dancop has quite a few profiles on the Apex, actually. There's a Dancop memory profile, which I'm personally very fond of. That's the only way I actually got my RAM to run properly. So, you know, that says something. Niuulh is currently still dialing in memory timings, and Dancop is already doing his first run, and he crashed. Blue screen, please. No.
Oh. No. It didn't crash.
No,
it's
no.
Good.
He made it. He made it. That benchmark is so confusing. 16, it just stops so abruptly.
16.507 point from Dancop. This is the first score here at the OCWC 2017. This is the final for the guys to win their entry tickets for the Overclocking World Championship grand final that's going to happen at the end of the year. They will be competing against 9 other overclockers that did in the same kind of concept. So what you can see here today is a 3D Mark 11 physics test. So this test is from supposedly 3D benchmark, so that means tested graphic cards, but the test we use is on
Dancop,
the
16.894.
The only test we use is only the physics test, so that does test the CPU on how it calculates the physics and collisions in between the different polygons on the screen.
Yeah, and Dancop is already running 6.5 gigahertz right now, and he's still making it through the runs. That CPU is good.
Dancop 17.154.
My God, it's just keeping increasing.
Yeah, he just keeps going. At some point, he's going to crash, then he's probably going to restart, and then he's going to raise the voltage and keep going up. That's pretty much what I expect to happen. Now, 3D Mark 11 physics is actually interesting in that while being a, you know, relatively heavy CPU benchmark,
Dancop,
it is actually pretty
17.320.
It is actually pretty heavily affected by memory overclocking. So it's not like he can just brute force his way with CPU frequency. And he is now at almost 6.7 gigahertz.
This is super hard benching. I mean, the guys, most of the people will never pass.
He's a freaking rocket. I would never imagine.
I mean,
running
there's a reason why this guy is number one in the world today, right?
Yeah. I mean, he, as far as I can tell, I think he's running cold bug free settings at this point. He's running, you know, quite well above 6.6 gigahertz. Admittedly, it just crashed, I think. Yes, it did.
Crash indeed.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, so quick to get this far. Niuulh is getting a run in right now. It will be interesting to see what kind of clocks he is at, as well as what score he gets.
Niuulh,
and that is
13.577.
So 13K,
that is very low.
13.5K, this is extremely low. This is even lower than what Dancop did started with.
We see the reason why. He's starting very safe.
That is basically the safe run. The safe run, that's something in competitions that people usually don't do, but they should be doing all the time, is they use one score that is at almost default settings, like basic settings that you are sure that's 100% that will pass. It allows you to have a score on the scoreboard, because there's some rules that if you don't have any scores, etc., there's some things that that can happen in the rules. But a score is always better than no score. So you see, now it just gained 1,000 points just like this. It just increased by 300 megahertz, and that gives him a boost of 300 points. And this is very important. Like, Bilzoid, what is your own techniques, and how do you read Niuulh doing right now and setting this score? Do you think, oh, and we got a blue screen! Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've never benchmarked, I haven't run KB Lake on liquid nitrogen yet. Okay? So I have no idea what I would do. That's pretty much my answer. KB Lake is, you know, it's a hard, from what I've been told, it's one of the harder architectures. Well, no, it's one of the hardest architectures to basically learn how to overclock. Skylake is the only one that's any worse, because it's like KB Lake, but worse in every way. But Yeah, it's like, I guess I would go for Niuulh's approach because it seems like it's more step by step. Though interestingly enough, Niuulh also has his memory settings really dialed in. Well, he dialed them in really early on, so that should give him quite. If he can reach similar clocks to Dancop, he could have an advantage just from the memory settings he has, because 3D Mark 11 is actually pretty memory intensive as far as CPU benchmarks go. It does scale well with memory. Memory performance, so
Dancop clocking 17.345. Bing.
And okay, so Dancop has figured that he's maxed out his CPU clock, and now he's working on the cache clock. So both of these guys are actually really they have a method to how they're going. Dancop admittedly is starting way higher up really, really quickly. And we got a blue screen!
Oh, this, you can see that the blue screen, they're going so close to the edge, even when the blue screen is lagging to display. This is something that almost never happens. It just straight goes to blue screen, and this one was just way too hard. This is when they're going so close to the limit. Thank you guys for joining in right now on Twitch. Let us know who you are actually cheering from. Are you cheering for Niuulh, the fourth best overclocker in France, a complete outsider to these competitions? He did start of extreme overclocking less than a year ago after watching one of these streams. It was like you before, he didn't knew that much about overclocking, didn't knew that much about the extreme overclocking world as well. And now he's competing against the world best overclocker, Dancop. On the other side, Dancop have been very consistent in the past few years to stay at the top. This is extremely difficult for the guys to do. And if you keep in mind that last year Dancop was as well in the final of this competition at the same location here, but sadly he never managed to submit any scores. This is something he wants to get his revenge on, and this is something he's definitely getting in. We are 20 minutes left into that game, and they are benching 3D Mark 11 physics.
So, Dancop seems to be starting to work on his memory at this point, as he does have the memory tab of CPU-Z open. 1466, I do believe. Now he's at 3433 memory clock right now. CPU-Z shows half effective clock, so, you know. For those of you unaware, that would be the equivalent of DDR4 3433, what he has right there. At 13, 18, 18, 28 timing. Actually, no, that's like 35, 33. I am off. Wait, I can't math. I can't multiply by two.
We do have
now. He's racing.
We do have Niuulh that is at 6.2 gigahertz. Now is at only 1.7 volt for the V core. There's still margin in the CPU under liquid nitrogen. Of course, that's -200 degrees. I can't see exactly how cold they are right now, but this is something very close from each other.
I'm gonna guess they're both running full pot at this point. Dancop is almost certainly running full pot. Niuulh, I'm not sure.
Niuulh 15.301.
So slightly but surely increasing his score once again.
Dancop 17.703.
Damn, like Niuulh is just trying to catch up, and Dancop is still running faster.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, he's started, like, we're seeing him tweak the BCLK more than the CPU clock and the cache clock. He actually has both of them relatively low to his best, like, maximum CPU
blue
clock and
screen! You were saying?
Well,
Niuulh 15.544.
Line increase, like, 240 points. But still, I mean, any increase is a good increase, right? So the goal for them is to be as close to the maximum the system can take. But the thing is, we don't know the maximum of the system because they add a random CPU they have to get. They got random memory. And yeah, you know, they have to tune in and just tweak exactly to the right settings they want. And Dancop so far is being very good at that. As you say, Bidzul, they have their techniques. They have their process.
Niuulh 15.952.
Their process and system.
Niuulh is certainly catching up now. And I mean, his clocks are starting to show for it at 6.5 gigahertz. He's not that far off Dancop's 6.6 plus frequencies that Dancop is currently running.
Dancop is going to be pitching at 6.5.
The last crash he got was above 6.5, well above 6.5. He was running really high BCLK.
Almost out of that game.
Niuulh 15.954.
He basically had his multiplier for both Uncore and Core Clock lower so that he could raise the BCLK to figure out the memory. I'm never going to get to finish my freaking sentences on this one, will I? These guys are just too many scores. Between Dan's crashing and the amount of scores coming out, I'm never going to get to finish anything, will I?
So you were saying they're restarting, so you have at least 45 seconds.
And there's nothing to talk about while they're restarting.
Oh my god. What about the platform? We can see that actually Niuulh didn't even fix the...
Niuulh's pot mounting is really, like, not sitting with me well. It's admittedly, he has one of the heaviest pots I'm aware of. He's running a Kingpin Cooling F1 Dark pot, and that is one giant hulking block of copper, and it is very heavy, so it generally, like, it stays where you put it generally, but you know, that mounting system, just for that extra certainty that it won't go anywhere, I think would have kind of helped, even if he's not gonna run any insulation here. Dancop is actually running the Derbauer Beast LN2 pot, so the Beast is like, so the F1 Dark is a more generally considered a sort of slower LN2 pot, very, very heavy, not a huge amount of surface area. The Beast is sort of it does everything, lots of surface area, very heavy. I do believe it's lighter than the actual Kingpin pot here that is being used by Niuulh, but the way the weight is actually distributed between them is actually very different. So the Beast is actually a lot more base heavy than the Kingpin pot, which being one giant piece of copper actually spreads a lot of its mass upwards, and you really want all of your mass right as close to the CPU as possible. So, you know, overall weight isn't the only statistic for determining a LN2. Like, overall weight and surface area don't tell you everything about an LN2 pod. Also, like, the design gets quite intricate on some of these coolers. So,
Dancop has reinstalled, actually, the benchmark. Reinsert the key.
Windows 10 strikes again. We've already had that happen once before today, where 3D Mark 11 had to be reinstalled. I've actually run into that issue with Windows 10 on 3D Mark Firestrike, where I'd have to reinstall that. I'm not entirely sure if that's specific to... I thought it was specific to 3D Mark Firestrike, but I guess it's just a Windows 10 thing where if you crash while running 3D Mark, it just forgets how to run itself. And I'm not joking about it. It just forgets what tests are currently installed on the system, so you end up having to reinstall the entire benchmark, which is not fun.
Niuulh 16.293.
Finally passing the barrier of the 16K score. That is good. He's catching up on Dancop, but there's less. We are more than halfway through the game already. I still have 12 minutes and 30 seconds left into increasing that score and maybe catching it with the 17K of Dancop. Dancop is very far ahead. Like, honestly, this is quite a huge advance in that specific state of and level of competition here.
Yeah, and we actually have less than half the competition still left to go, so time is running out. I do believe we actually saw a higher physics score today, though, on an earlier competition today, very briefly.
I have a very bad memory, so I could not tell.
I think we have. I'm not 100% sure either.
But the key is they will never be able to reuse the same CPU in the qualifier. So that means one CPU that was already used before cannot be reused after. And we can.
Well, I don't think either of these guys actually had that CPU, so it wouldn't technically matter.
So 6.4 gigahertz for Niuulh, the cache ratio is at 6 gigahertz. So this is something completely across the limits compared to the amateur that we had just a few hours ago here at the OCWC17.
Yeah, this is way, way higher clocks, of course. Before we were looking at, you know,
16.341.
Before we were looking at 4 gigahertz range clocks, and now we're looking well into the 6 gigahertz range. This is partly because just Kaby Lake clocks significantly better than Broadwell E does. I mean, even on water cooling, Kaby Lake relatively easily does 5 gigahertz. And then when you add liquid nitrogen to Kaby Lake, it just goes like a rocket compared to a lot of other CPU architectures in the same scenario. And Dancop is, Dancop's running well above, he's going for a 6.6 gigahertz. Yeah. Just over, because he does have the base clock bumped up a little bit. It'll be interesting to see if he manages to finish this. He should be able to, except it crashed.
That's the benchmark being launched. Can see there's numbers below. That's the number of FPS and frames calculated in the benchmark. This actually results in a very complex calculation in the score in the end. And the scores is not improving 17K, but 468. This is maybe is like a step one score. So that's the score you do, you test, and then you go increase. You cannot just go full out to the top score that you had. Usually it's a little bit more tricky than that.
Yeah, for the blue screen.
Okay, could you hear that? Wait for the blue screen. Yeah. Blue screen! I dodge it.
Want some more?
He's doing it on purpose. Actually, last year, Dancop in the competition we had in Taipei, Taiwan, he was like counting with the crowd, like 1, 2, 3, 4, blue screen. That was crazy.
I want to get a chance to call one of these blue screens ones. But with me being on delay, that doesn't work out that great. Niuulh has quite the gap to actually catch up here, because he is significantly behind in frequency and score. And there's only 8 minutes, you know, less than 9 minutes actually left to go now. So not much time left. We're giving away keys now.
Oops.
Yeah, good job.
Wait for that.
Too late.
Well, if you guys use it and bench with that, that's just going to end up
on Dancop
5. So you're going to be benching for him. I don't think it does need
actually
that.
No, wouldn't that be like a HW bot key? So you would just end up benching for like the HW bot account. So well, it wouldn't actually be your score.
Right. Niuulh is benching again. Maybe he can increase his score of 16.3K. This is like more than 1,200 points behind Dancop. Work? Will it work?
He's actually scored lower than his own best, so he's got some, like, he's got his work cut out for him in the next 7 minutes 30 seconds that are left in this competition. Dancop is failing to actually improve his score as well. Keeps raising the BCLK. Okay, that's a really good way to get blue screens a lot. So
he's kind of expecting that.
Yep. But at the same time, it does.
No, it's not.
Oh boy! Are we gonna have it?
Here he comes! Here he comes!
Just got!
It would really suck if it just kept hanging on this until he has to restart the system. Crashed so hard, even the blue screen can't blue screen.
That it's like he was expecting it. He did actually dodge it. He did announce that there's going to be a blue screen. And in fact, it did not happen. Well, so far he's in the lead, so he can do that kind of stuff because that's something fun. Well,
At the same time, the raising of the BCLK does have, technically, it gives you more performance gain than raising like one ratio at a time, because it increases memory performance, uncore performance, and core clock performance at core performance at the same time, because it overclocks all of those at the same time. It's also the reason why it's much more likely to cause a, you know, blue screen, because you're raising a lot more frequencies at the same time, and there's very little chance that all of them are stable at
Dancop
the same time.
17810.
My God, it
and the BCLK
whatsoever.
Increasing has paid off. He's increased his score by over 100 points.
Niuulh is like, oh my God, there's nothing I can do against that. It's like, oh. But still, there's like 6 minutes back, 6 minutes in this game. Maybe he can still do something.
You
and
can
add
see 6.6 gigahertz.
Will it run? Will it run? Okay, guys, back at home in good cheer. Wait
oh
for
my.
It. Wait for
it's
it.
Running.
Actually, this is
it's running. It's running.
Oh my God.
That was the end of the benchmark.
Yes. Oh, the score was invalid. It crashed, yeah.
So that's interesting. Lowering the core voltage is not something I would ever consider doing.
So we did talk about a profile. They cannot load profile before. They cannot load profile that is built in the motherboard. But they can save the profile they just do by hand. So they can just go back to that later on. I mean, in 30 minutes, that is something that passed super, super fast. I mean, we have been already 25 minutes into this game. Oh!
Here it comes. Oh.
No. He dodged it. In 30 minutes, this is extremely fast as a match.
I think he's going for that blue screen. He keeps lowering the voltage. He must know what that's going to do. Did we get it? Did we get our blue screen?
No, I think just going to... Oh, wait.
You know, it's very fitting that Dancop is the player in blue. He gives us the most blue screens.
And we have 4 minutes left in this final of the OCWC 2017 here in Poitiers. That's the qualifier to know who will get to the Overclocking World Championship World Final by the end of the year. Seems that the settings it did change did not work as expected. Niuulh is still struggling with this system as well. I mean, it doesn't manage to make it boot anymore. It was trying to boot at 1.61 volt. So as you can see, the voltage they are using are extremely high. The main reason for that is just because they can, and they are cooling it down with liquid nitrogen. So this is something they could do for that. So as you can see, 1.61 volt for the core voltage. This is the voltage that is applied to the system to start with. And the memory voltage is close to 2 volts, like 1.96. Once again, even though the memory is not under liquid nitrogen, it is cooled down by the smoke of the LN2.
3 minutes.
Well, basically by proximity, yeah.
Yeah, by proximity.
And but the other thing is a lot of DDR4 memory actually prefers to stay at ambient temperatures. So getting it cold actually is the opposite of what you want to do. I do believe some of the memory modules actually have issues where they will randomly blue screen if they get too cold. They'll actually clock higher, like they'll scale with the cold, but they'll not stay stable. So,
and
yeah, DDR4 is
here, especially for everyone that tune in now here, they don't try to be stable for playing games or 24/7. They're just playing to be able to run the benchmark. So the benchmark is, as you can see, less than 15 seconds to run. This have to be stable enough to do the scores and have the scores at the end. That's it. That's going to be a valid score here for the competition. And we have 2 minutes left! 2 minutes left in that game.
Both 2 minutes.
Overclockers are trying to restart. The rule says they have to run the benchmark before the end of the timer, and the correct timer is actually the one from the judge. So once the judge says over, that's going to be over for them. They have to run the benchmark before. So far, that seems very difficult for Niuulh to go back in the games. I wish he could actually pass the barrier of the 17K score. That would be something very good. But there's only 1 minute and 30 seconds left in this game, and Dancop is going back at it. Oh, it seems that I've crashed.
I think it crashed.
Yeah. Crashed on the loading screen.
Wait all for right. it. No. Saved.
Hard reset. All right, so
it got saved.
Is at 1.905 volt for the core voltage, 1.95 for the memory, and he's benching back at 6.1 gigahertz.
Last minute.
At this point, I think last ditch effort would be a good idea. You know, just whack the voltage really high, pray for the mess, so put the frequency high, smash the voltage, and hope for the best. At this point, it can't go wrong.
Yeah, it seems like Niuulh is not capable of benching as of now. He's waiting for the system to restart. We do have a blank screen, and then, yeah. So as you can see, there's less than 30 seconds left, and they're both restarting the system. Would they have the time to submit one more score? Keep in mind that they have to click the run button just before the end of the timer.
15 seconds.
Dancop is very hard at it. Load this profile. Just gonna change the DCLK very quick.
5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, time's up.
It's just gonna run it for the
run
game.
From Dancop, we let it finish.
It's just gonna run for the game. Maybe he's gonna be increasing his score, or maybe that's we're gonna give one last
blue screen. A final blue screen?
That'd be nice. That's a hard reset.
Not quite unstable enough to crack
the
blue screen.
Congratulations with 17,810 points. We got our champion.
Impressive display of skills by here and current number one in the world, Dancop. Niuulh displayed quite some interesting, fighting. Even though I think he came a little bit unprepared. As you can see, his CPU was mounting like the CPU pod, the piece of copper that is cooling down with liquid nitrogen on it, was not actually mounted completely on the motherboard. For some, it is a style of benching. For some others, this is something they just never do because they just don't want to do it. Buildzoid, what can you get out of this match? What do you think how do you think the guys did?
Well, I think Dancop thought he had a CPU advantage going in just based on the fact that he was going for basically anything. It was a Super Pi 8 million, which was an unlimited run. Then 3D Mark 11 actually came up. In terms of the actual benching, this really showed, you could really see the difference between, world number one and somebody who basically
in the world, yeah.
Yeah, who didn't even know, like who picked up overclocking, I do believe you said last year or roughly a year ago.
Roughly a year ago at the exact same event here, Dancop was here in the final. He accessed the final, but sadly, he never managed to boot into Windows, so he never managed to pass by the BIOS. There was something going wrong with his system. He never found out what was the issue. He never found out how was the issue. Actually, after the competition, it just ditched the motherboard anymore. It never went back to it. I think it was a bit pissed that it could not qualify from this specific event.
Right.
But in the end, it did qualify at the another event after. So that was okay for him. But I mean, you're currently number one in the world, like Dancop, and you basically display everything you can do with a system like this. Built to it, we can see that they are actually having torch and blower into that. For everyone that just joined us here, we just finished the OCWC 2017 final qualifier. We're gonna move on to the award ceremony pretty soon. Just before we move to the award ceremony, why did they use the torch and the blower?
So the heat gun and the blowtorch serve well. So the main reason why you need them is if you hit a cold boot bug, you need to be able to warm the system. Or, you hit a cold bug or a cold boot bug, you need to be able to pull the system temperature above that temperature where the system stops working, and then you can start the system again. Now, here they were using them because, well, they finished benchmarking, and honestly, just waiting for the system, like waiting for, you know, very heavy copper LN2 containers to just melt the water off of them, melt the ice and then just have the water drip down, takes a while. So basically they were just torching and heat gunning the LN2 pots to basically warm them up faster so they could disassemble the system sooner. That's really all there is to it at this point.